Try an email. Recently, I've noticed a sensation in my balls that feels like someone is constantly squeezing them. This coincides with the fact that I've recently abstained from masturbation. I wonder what it could be.
Yeah.
Then I broke up with my girlfriend recently. So far, it's been about 21 days since. Why do you make me even attempt to get me to read some of this?
So he hasn't masturbated.
21 days, broke up with a girlfriend.
21 days.
Hasn't had any discharge.
Okay.
I know everyone's heard of blue balls, but I've never felt this pain before. I was wondering if this was normal. It really does feel like I'm getting kicked in the balls by a baby's foot. It makes me think that I'm unhealthy to abstain for this long.
You are.
It's unhealthy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And usually God takes care of it. God will take care of it during the night.
Yeah. And here's the thing that, and Dr. Drew, tell me if I'm wrong, but the human body normally lets you know when you're doing something bad to it.
Pain.
Yeah, pain.
Discomfort. Well, you know, this is sort of a funny thing because blue balls has, I'm talking about it as though it's a clinical term, but this is.
It should be.
It's pelvic congestion.
The seminal
vesicles fill up with seminal fluid.
Yes.
The prostate becomes irritated. The lymphatic tissue starts to engorge down. There's a lot of reason, but people don't understand it has almost nothing to do with the testicles though. The testicles are just this organ that produces testosterone and a tiny trickle of cells back up to the seminal vesicles to mix in with the semen, which is produced by the prostate.
Mm.
And so the balls feel uncomfortable because that's where all the congestion is sort of, it's all in that pelvic area.
Okay.
So there you go. And let God do it at night or maybe you just be healthy. And
Now.
What's he trying to prove? Does he also wash his clothes in the bathtub?
He gave it up for Lent, maybe. Maybe he gave up jerking off for Lent.
Mm-hmm. He's gone cold jerky. We have to get
cold
him.
Jerky.
I've noticed every time I have a bowel movement, this is a female, there is an abundance of vaginal discharge. I've noticed it is excreted right before the bowel movement after wiping. I was curious to why. I know a few episodes ago, a gentleman mentioned sperms come out when he has a bowel movement. Evidently, that was one of our more popular emails.
Ooh.
And I wonder what the correlation is for women.
It's called a blumpkin.
Not sure, no. If it was just me, I just want to know.
Do not Google blumpkin. If you're like, what's that? Google it. Don't do it.
The pelvic... I feel like I'd have like a pelvic architecture picture up here so people could understand what I'm talking about.
I could
about.
Just stand here. I'm about the size of a chart.
Lean you up and cut you in half.
Yeah.
Point is The uterus and the vagina right up against the rectum. They're sort of all right in the same zone. And so things that are moving through one can affect the other.
I just realized something, Dr. Drew.
What's that?
I'm 35 years old.
Yeah.
That means in 5 years I'm going to be 40.
Okay. I can do the math.
I know, and you are a doctor and you are a friend. At some point, your finger's probably going to be at my ass.
I understand the correlation. And how
at
you're
some
thinking.
Point... At some point, your finger's probably going to be in my ass.
But the friend part does not increase the probability of a finger going in your
I mean, the fact
and
that
the doctor part means I'd have to be your doctor, which I can't also be your friend.
The
be
fact
your doctor,
that
so
I'm somewhat frugal, I can go...
You're going to make me do it, is what you're saying.
I mean, I can get a free finger up the ass to check my prostate from a doctor.
Kimmel brought up the other day that I had done that with him years ago.
Yes.
And of course, it was when he was the color guy in the morning show on K-Rock.
Yes.
And Kevin showed up with a tape recorder.
Yes.
In the room with us.
So all I'm saying is what you are seeing is two men who are... who have not had any sexual contact whatsoever,
but will.
In the future,
but
will.
Thank you for that.
And that's why I think there's
I'm
a tension between
so
us.
So forward to it, man. Woo!
Get a good look at that.
I just
All
want
right,
you to know that
which
I,
finger do you use? Which finger do you use?
That I just want you
the
to
index.
Know that
it, the longest one.
Just think about.
Is that just for me or is that clinical?
That's everybody.
Okay.
But my personal savior. He's going to have his my finger up his ass. That's the part that
you're
going to
be spinning me
with.
Like a Harlem Globetrotter spins a ball.
That should be in a cartoon or a t-shirt or something. About 15 years ago, it's a miracle this one's titled. 15 years ago, I was shot 5 times. As a result, I became paraplegic. I spent nearly four years in a wheelchair, and I slowly began to reuse my legs. Wow. Ever since this incident, having an orgasm has become somewhat painful, and I've noticed that urine is released along with the ejaculate. Mm-hmm. Also, ever since the shooting, I have to urinate frequently all throughout the day and haven't been able to sleep for more than 2 hours at a time.
Boy.
Any thoughts to why this is? I don't understand why you
why
are...
Why can't you sleep, though?
Because he's having to pee every 2 hours. You can use a catheter. But
use
you have
a catheter
to,
or a diaper.
Yeah, but probably...
Use a diaper and sleep.
Yeah, but it probably still would wake him up. And I guess this is a male, yeah.
Okay. So what's the question?
The bottom line is that because of the spinal injury, the ejaculation contractions are not coordinated properly. And also the sort of the flap that keeps the urine in and that lets the ejaculate out is sort of dysfunctioning a little bit, which can happen. All this can happen after a spinal cord injury. It seems like there might have been a damage to your autonomic nervous system as well. What I don't understand is why you haven't brought this up with your team, because urological problems and bowel problems are sort of part of the whole paraplegic thing. You got to deal with all that stuff and come up with a plan.
Is there a way, because he says that having an orgasm is painful for him.
Yeah.
Is there a way?
I bet there's a medicine that can make that. I'm thinking of medicines that can release some of those muscles that make it less painful.
Is there a way he can kind of Pavlov dog this, and every time he has an orgasm, like hit
himself
or do something else
take a needle and poke himself in the hand?
So like,
where he has
so like the pain comes with pleasure. So now he starts to get off
I
on the
think
pain.
You're thinking like your dad here.
And yeah, the, let's
and
use it.
No, I don't think so.
Wait, I'm not thinking. Wait, unless my dad's into some really kinky shit.
No,
that I don't
your
know
dad
about.
Is into what he has done is he's sort of a behavior therapist. He made things more painful for you, so when you go out in the world, things were not so painful.
Yeah.
Well, I understand that's where your head goes.
You need more. You need more pain.
But this is these kinds of things are not at all. So this person has a spinal cord transection, somewhere in the lumbar, mid-thoracic spine or something. And the interesting thing is that he's getting his legs back, which is fantastic.
It's amazing.
Yeah, it's fabulous.
Well done.
But he's still having some of these urological problems. I would see a urologist. I'm sure there's things that can help this. It's about relaxing some of those muscles that are around the bladder neck.
Mm.
All right. I've been ahead of a sexual relationship for almost 2 years. She makes me the happiest I've ever been. Here's the deal, man. Although she brings me great joy, I don't find myself attracted to her physically or sexually.
Mm.
This is a problem.
Yes.
She wants to have sex often, give me an array of clues between things like blah, blah, blah. The problem is I find myself romanticizing sleeping with women very frequently throughout the day. Oh, my God. At first, I attributed this to watching too much porn. That may be true as well. Mm. Now I find myself fantasizing about attractive women that I see at work. I feel like I'm comparing them too much to my girlfriend.
So he's married?
Girlfriend.
Oh. This is only supposed to happen once you're like 10 years into marriage.
Did not happen to me. This is very frustrating because I do not want to keep ignoring my girlfriend's needs, but this is not a good situation. I hate to say it.
Well, it's like what you have now is a really good friend. And that's it.
I for most couples, the physical spark is very, very important. Even if it is waning or if it's minimal, it's really important. It's what bonds people together. And a mismatched sexual desire is a tough thing to manage, especially when you're not attracted to the other person.
And that's... Is there any way that he could find something about her that he is attracted to and just focus on that?
Correct. And men are really good at that. Because men can compartmentalize and we can look at like parts of, we break people down into parts and visual parts.
Maybe he could try being a furry where she has to wear the suit of a pink squirrel or something. And then he fucks the squirrel.
All good advice.
And then he could look, and now he's looking at a pink squirrel, which is more attractive than his ugly ass girlfriend.
We didn't know she's ugly. We just know that he's not attracted to her. And Brad Williams with a somewhat solid advice. A little bleak, but somewhat solid.
No, like,
we're just looking for solutions.
You make something work if you truly want to be with her. But as I will tell where I have friends that are women that say like, oh, this guy that I'm with, you know, he never calls me. He insults me. Blah, blah, blah. I go, then leave.
Yeah.
There's someone out there that will check those boxes.
Right. That's the bottom line, that people get into these romantic relationships and they don't feel that they can ever leave them. They can't untangle from
you
them.
Can.
You almost have to because it's not really working. It's not fair to her. If she knew you were feeling like this, she wouldn't want you to be in this.
No. Now, here's the only way that you...
And by the way, there will be somebody who's totally into her and that person should be with her.
And here's the only way you can't leave. Is
you're married and you have kids.
No.
Then you don't.
No. You could leave, but then have an arrangement. but like, here's the only way you can't leave is if she is like, if this guy is really ugly and this woman is the best that he could do, then you can't leave. Cause you're not like, you know what I mean?
So if there's a numbers mismatch and he's on the wrong end.
If she's a 7.
Yeah.
You're a 2, and but you still wish she was an 8.
I
not going to happen.
I still don't think that's fair to her.
It's not. I'm saying like you have no reason. You have to just kind of like, maybe this is the best you can do. And that's where the porn comes in, where you watch these porn stars and you think, oh, I have to fuck a woman that looks like that.
The whole problem could be the porn.
Could be. I
mean, he had to go again cold jerky for a while on the porn and see if
you know what. Here's what you do. You could go to prison.
He'd be better then.
And then when you get out, you'll be like,
yeah,
you're the hottest thing I've ever seen in my life.
That's one solution.
Or you guys go and you join the Peace Corps together, and you go to some third world country.
That's another solution.
That's like horrible, and you just look at her like you've never.
Or just stop watching the goddamn porn.
Because listen. My wife is fantastic. She's gorgeous. She's beautiful. I am sexually attracted to my wife. I am in awe of her. There's no way I should be with her. Yeah. But sometimes I live in Los Angeles.
That, by the way, that's in fact
that you're also very sexually attracted to her. I get it.
No, you should not be with her. You don't deserve her. That's what I meant.
I would say that living in Los Angeles is probably similar to living in a city like Miami or the entire fucking country of Brazil, where sometimes you look around, you go, oh, and you see these gorgeous, amazing women there, go, oh, that's normal. It's not. Travel the world, travel the country. You'll go, spend some time in Des Moines. You know?
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Be happy with what you got.
Spend some time in Des Moines.
Bottom line.